Hello, D-Light Channel. You are welcome to the Development, Empowerment and Leadership Initiative NGO. We have been talking about money management over the last couple of weeks. I'm glad you are able to make it again this week. Thanks for joining me. And where are we on that journey? If you've missed the past videos, you've missed a lot, sincerely, you really need to go and watch, because we've covered what is money, definition of assets and liabilities, the different channels through which your inflow can go out, what you need to do with consumption, how you need to prioritize assets over liability, how do you go about creating assets. And this week we are at the point where we are saying, what are the types of assets that you may want to invest in? Now, we can go on and define them in different classifications. It's a lot, a whole lot. But for the purpose of classification and simplification, I would like to classify them into three different categories. So you have the cash, you have the near cash, and you have the non-cash. Now, let me lay certain fundamentals clearly here before we go forward. The first is that whatever you do, whatever investment you try to do, ensure that you have some amount of cash readily available, as in cash. There is a saying that cash is king. Many times, opportunities arise that only those who have cash are able to seize it. So what I'm saying in essence is that the ideal mix, as you get bigger and better in your investment journey, is to ensure that you have a mix of the three. Never ever get to the point where, no matter the returns it is promising, you have all your investment in non-cash. There must always be a mix of assets. You should have those that are long term, which are usually the non-cash. You should have those that are medium term, which are the near cash. And you have those that are short term, which are the cash. Now, whether these investments are in real estate, they are in shares, they are in setting up organizations, they are in businesses that you are trying to run, whichever vehicle you decide to adopt for your investment, always remember that the mix of the three is optimal for you when you are thinking of creating assets. So what you then need to do is that when you have aggregated sufficient amount of cash, depending on your areas of knowledge, and this is very important, like I said in last week's video, do not invest in assets that you do not understand the fundamentals. So when you have aggregated enough amount of cash, you then need to start from the familiar. At least if you are very familiar with landed properties, which is one of the very popular assets that you can invest in, I'm talking about real estate, you need to learn to do your due diligence. I want to speak particularly about real estate. And my warning about real estate is as follows. Number one, if you are not ready to develop and occupy, be very careful in acquiring real estate, particularly on developed properties. I can tell you a lot of stories about how much money you sincerely have lost in landed properties that I was not ready to develop. Unless where you are, there are clear rules that can protect your investment in real estate. But if you are living in a typical third world where the rules around landed properties and real estate is very fluid, one of the questions you need to always ask yourself as you make that decision is, am I able to occupy? Am I able to possess? Because in addition to doing all the due diligence, doing the verification of the ownership of the title, of the market price, and ensure you are getting a fair bargain, if you go through all that and you are not ready in the immediate now to move in and occupy, whether it is just to fence or even to develop something simple on it or to just turn it into an agreed investment, if you are not occupying consciously and deliberately, by the time you are ready, you may never be able to lay hold or lay claim to that investment. That's number one. The next investment I want to speak about is investment in publicly quoted companies. You need to really study and ask questions. There are good times to buy, there are bad times to buy, depending on what you are looking for. Are you playing for the short run? Are you playing for the long run? Also, for such organizations, you need to be aware, I repeat, of their fundamentals, and at the same time, keep your eye on government policies and regulation. A company that thrives because it can import certain raw materials to produce some finished goods that can be sold in the market, and all of a sudden you start hearing that government is planning to ban the importation of that raw material and there are no easy substitutes in the local market, you need to make up your mind whether you want to stay or you want to move. Meaning that when it comes to investment in shares, it's a lot intricate and you need to seek advice and take your time to study. But whatever you do, you need to remember that if you are looking for quick returns, then shares may not be your route there, because anybody investment in shares, unless you got tons of money, is a slow game that you need time and you must be patient for it to accumulate and become something very material. That will be number two. Number three, and which is very heavy for me, is investment in all these Ponzi scheme type of investments. I said it before, I'm saying it again. Once you cannot understand the value that that organization is creating, because it is when the organization creates value and then makes money that you are able to share out of that money. I don't care whether they call it cryptocurrency, whether they call it MMM, XXX, YYY, ZZZ, whatever the name is, once it is not clear what value is being created by this organization, that you can now see whether that value is short-term, long-term, or mid-term, if you invest in it, you are playing lottery. Obviously, some people will always win in such schemes. Those who are smart, they go in early, they divest, and they run. Some, they will follow somebody else as, and I know somebody, and then before they know it, the roof comes crashing on their head. So, when it comes to anything you do not understand the fundamentals, you need to stay away from it. And therefore, in summary, what we are saying is that, one, ensure you understand the fundamentals of any investment before you get into it. Two, you must make up your mind whether you are playing for the short run or for the long run, because different investments have different gestation periods. Three, seek counsel. Don't use native intelligence. Ask questions. Four, be deliberate to have a mix of asset type in your portfolio. You should have some that are long term. You should have some that are mid-term, and you should have some that are here and now. And when I say here and now, I mean you should have a portion of your investment in cash. Why? Cash is king. Then, before I run off, if you get it right and you have the right mix and you pay close attention to your investment and you know when to sell, you know when to buy, you know when to stay, you know what to do when, you need to always remember that you will not always get all your decisions right. So because you've gotten the decision wrong is not the reason for you to abandon investment. Believe me, go and check the Forbes list of millionaires. You will not see any employee there. The only way to get to that level of comfort is when you learn to invest. So because you have lost in one decision or there was one bad decision, is not the reason for you to abandon ship and stop investing. And even if you lose, make sure you do not lose the lesson. That is the message. Then, when you succeed, what do you do with the returns? Is it time to go and marry a new wife? To go and buy a new car? The same discipline that got you there is the same discipline you need to apply. You must have a reinvestment policy. There must be something that says, whatever returns I make on my investment, X percent, I recommend 90%, 80% should go back as reinvestment. And then the 20% can be for you, add it to your income, and apply the same discipline between consumption, asset creation, liability creation, and charities. The truth of the matter is that even though we are trying to achieve financial independence, we should not stop living. I say that again. We should not stop living. So, learn to live. Do not suspend living simply because you are trying to build financial independence or a financial castle. All right? And the last thing there is that learn to give. If you succeed in winning the battle against poverty, let it not just be about you. Learn to share, learn to give. It is your way to immortality. When you look at successful people, that's what they end up doing after building such very, very big financial base. So, thanks for being here this week. But there is one more option you have when it comes to investment, and that is entrepreneurship. That will be the focus for next week's video. It is time for you to buckle up and get ready for a new direction in our conversation. Thanks for being here once again this week. T-Mark is still my name, and all I'm trying to do is what? Make a little difference. See you next week. Bye.